Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and Christmas is coming. We all know Christmas is coming. It's November now. Well, I'm filming this the week before November, so it might be November when this video comes out. Working in the music biz, talking about guitars and amplifiers and all the fun stuff that we adore so dearly, I get asked all the time, not just by YouTube comments or Instagram comments or Facebook comments, but also by my friends and family, what do they ask for Christmas? Or what should I buy my brother or my sister or my mum or my dad or my son or my daughter for Christmas, guitar-wise? Because there's so many things out there which all look really, really fun, and people don't really have a clue what they do if you're not a guitar player. So in this video, I want to pick you through some of my favourites. First, I want to show you five of my favourite things for under 50 quid, then three of my favourite things for under £100, and then three of my favourite things for under £500. And like I said, there's so many different offerings out there available. So comment down below if you want to add anything or expand on anything, if you want to add something to these three brackets which you think people out there should consider when buying or asking for a gift for themselves or buying a guitar gift for someone else. So let's get straight into it with my five favorite 20 quid gift ideas for early Christmas gifts. Now, when I say early Christmas gifts, I mean to buy early for them, to then give it to them at Christmas. Don't give them earlier than Christmas because they don't deserve an early Christmas present. And you know why. I'm not going to tell you why, but you know why. So this is to early Christmas gifts to save all the stress of buying closer to Christmas. Yeah, also worth mentioning, I'm not actually going to mention any specific prices in this video because prices do fluctuate every other week with where the pound is at the minute, because it's absolutely rad, even though it's just like by 20 pence or something. Some of these items are actually priced with a sticker, but it might be wrong by the time this video comes out. So everything is linked in the description box down below, so you can check it out at pmtonline.co.uk. I'll just kind of put them in brackets from 50, 100 to 200. Let's talk about one of my favorite things and a must have first for any guitar player out there, especially if you're considering gigging, and that is strap locks. Now, strap locks are something that lock your strap onto your guitar. They come in two separate bits. One bit replaces the button of your guitar, because every guitar comes with strap buttons here. One bit replaces that, and the other bit affixes itself to the strap, either with a little, like a screw or a little clamp system. So it's constantly, I've got one of mine here. Little metal bit on a strap. Clamps like that, stays there, and then it locks onto the guitar. So you can do guitar spins, and this isn't gonna happen. It's not just gonna fall off like that. And for under 50 quid, you can get my favorite strap locks of all time. Schaller. I've got these on all of my guitars, Schaller strap locks. There's a few out, there's a few different variants like Goto strap locks, Dunlop strap locks, Fender do them, Daddario, Ernie Ball do them, but Schaller is my absolute favorite. Come in a few different variations of colors, gold, black, silvers, nickels, but they're great. And I think every guitar player needs this either as a stocking filler for Christmas or just a must have. Maybe this is something you should give your kid before Christmas or give your husband or wife before Christmas, because if they've got a Christmas gig coming up and you're saving this for Christmas, if they do guitar spin and the guitar goes and breaks, you don't want that, so give them these before Christmas, okay? Next up, again, another gift that every guitar player needs to get in their life from a loved one is a good guitar stand. Now, guitar stands, you can get cheap ones out there, like those folding airframes, and they're okay, but they're big, cumbersome, and they kind of only fold so. Like, not enough is what really guitar players need to travel with guitars, their guitar stands, fuck with their guitars. This is a GS302B. I also keep forgetting the name, but it's one of the flat Hercules ones. So this is an electric guitar stand. They do acoustic guitar stands as well. The guitar lies in here, sits in there, and lies against the back right here. And two cool things about Hercules. They're very sturdy, they're awesome, and it folds away nice and thin, so it fits in the front pocket of a gig bag, or like say on a suitcase, it'll just sit nicely on the top of all your clothes and stuff. Those airframes can be a bit ridiculous. And the cheaper airframes, this is one of the most important things. If you've got like a nice Gibson or a PRS or a Fender with nitrocellulose lacquer, the cheap airframes might actually burn through the lacquer with the rubber and the plastic used. The soft rubber on the Hercules stands, no matter what kind of variant you get, is specifically designed to not affect any fancy nitrocellulose lacquer or tarnish anything on your guitar, any hardware, any binding. They're great. And yeah, they're extremely sturdy. This is one of my favorites, and it's worth spending a bit more for a guitar stand because of the reasons I've just mentioned. And I use this one. It's linked down below. Check it out. Next up, a gift you can never go wrong with if you're buying for a loved one who is a musician. We always need new cables just in case. And again, same with the stand, if you spend a bit more, you will just get better, not even that little, that much more, you will get a better cable. And these Fender cables are awesome. These are the Festival cables. And not only are they great quality with 24 karat gold connectors, big thick insulation, but these Festival cables are 100% eco-friendly. They're made from hemp and they come in very, very cool, old school kind of festival-y Woodstock kind of vibes. It's a nice little unique quirky gift to get a guitar player. It's better than a regular cable. It looks cool, it's eco-friendly, and yeah, I love these Fender cables because hemp and that. But besides how awesome the eco-friendly nature of this cable is, the better the cable, the better the sound quality. People might think cables are cables, but if you go on YouTube and listen to people try cheap cables all the way through to expensive cables, there is quite a difference. There's not a lot of signal degradation in these wonderful big thick Fender cables, so seriously consider these, getting them either for yourself or as a gift. Next up! Marshall MS2. These fabulous little Marshall half stacks aren't a lot of money. They run on a 9-volt battery and there's a little belt clip. So if you're a guitar player that wants to be on the move and play guitar when you're away camping with the family, or you're staying over at someone's house, or you're in a hotel for an evening, this will fit in the guitar case, whether it be a hard case in the pocket in the middle or the bag of a soft case. Again, fit in a suitcase or wherever. Great. Great little thing. Clean sound, overdriven sound, one volume, one tone control, and it looks like a tiny little Marshall amplifier. And like I said, there's a little belt clip on the back, so you can either have it like that on the front of you, or on a table or your belt, or whatever. There's also a headphone line out, so you can silently practice and get the sound of a guitar without going through the speakers. If you're in a hotel and you have to be quiet for next door neighbors, it does run on 9-volt power as well, like pedals and stuff, but yeah. This is a great little gift, it's useful, and even if they don't use it, it looks really cool on like a desk or something. It's a tiny little Marshall stack. You can't get the bigger one, but for now, for bang for your buck, the MS2, the small one, is awesome. Last but certainly not least on the under 50 quid gift you should get for guitar players, the Blackstar Amplug 2 Fly. Now, talk about silent practicing with the Marshall before with the headphone line out. That's all well and good, but if you want to be proper discreet and get tones from a Blackstar that you're very familiar with, clean crunch and proper overdriven lead tones, the Fly 3 is awesome. This is a tiny little box of joy which plugs into the input of your guitar and then headphones directly out into headphones. There's an EQ control up top, there's built-in effects and everything. I can't really demo it because I can't hear it in my own head, but there's plenty of stuff. I'll link some in the description box down below. Check out Blackstar's website where they go in depth with this little thing. But seriously, it's a game changer when it was released. There's other videos online about the Amplug 2 as well. But yeah, this is the ultimate way to get more. It doesn't look as cool as the Marshall MS2, but for the guitar, the electric guitar player on the move that wants a nice little kind of Swiss Army thing, like amp almost, without having to carry an amp or plug into your phone or mobile device or anything stupid like that, the amp plugs are great. These things sell like hotcakes around the Christmas time as well, so you've got to nab these while you can. The Blackstar Amplug 2. Play on the fly! This pedal is one of my favorite pedals of all time. Everyone's gotta have one, but let's not get ahead of ourselves here. These are the three lovely guitar goodies I believe you should get for under 100 quid. Everything here, just like the rest of the products in this video, will be loved by the guitar player who you're getting this for. First thing, probably most amazed by the name, this is a Big Muff, an Electro-Harmonix Big Muff, one of the most iconic overdrive pedals of all time, and it's not a lot of money. Not because it's cheap and crappy, because it's a very simple overdrive pedal that's iconic and it's made on such mass numbers they can afford to make it nice and cheap for us to enjoy. It's a girl like it's so good. It makes the hairs on your neck stand up when you play through a big muff. It's awesome. It's an overdrive pedal that's very fuzzy and fluffy. It's very sweet. You can get like violin-esque sustain and rich harmonic overtone. So many stupid guitar words happening at sometimes, and sometimes you want to blow people's faces off. David Gilmour, the Black Keys, Jack White, obviously big lovers of the big muff, and they do make small pedals of the big muff, which you can buy, like the Nano and stuff. It's got the same circuit. The circuit isn't actually that complicated and that big inside of this. You can buy more pedal board friendly versions, but the original was this big, and it's ridiculous looking, and it says big muff on it. For the same price, I would much rather have the original, because it looks ridiculous. Three controls: volume, how loud you want the pedal to be; tone, do you want a bright sound or a dark fuzz; or a bright fuzz, and the sustain on the right for how much sustain, how much gain you want, pretty much. Everyone's gonna have a big muff at some point, even if you don't have for a long time or you don't really use it. To look at, it's just iconic, and so many famous guitar players have utilized this, and now you can too, for Christmas, or get someone to utilize it for themselves for Christmas. Next up, let's talk about another legendary overdrive pedal, a legendary pedal that you can get for under £100. It's the iconic Vox V847A wah pedal. Now, everyone knows like Crybaby and stuff, but Vox also make wahs, you probably already know this. And everyone who was everyone used a Vox wah back in the 60s, and this is a faithful recreation of that original 60s wah pedal used by Jimi Hendrix, used by Jimmy Page, used by Steve Ray Vaughan. They all used Vox wah pedals, and this, like I say, is a faithful recreation. Aesthetically, it's beautiful. It's exactly the same as the original ones, with the kind of rough and ready lower casing, but that beautiful, stunning chrome bit up top. It's a wah pedal. It's simple. You stand on it and sound like Jimi Hendrix. And this is the one that Jimi Hendrix used to use back in the day. It's powered by a 9-volt battery or a little 9-volt power supply in the back there. And this is what it sounds like. Made me swap feet. So, 100 quid, under 100 quid, if you don't want to delve into the world of pedals, say they might already have too many pedals, the Marshall MS-1 is awesome for under 50 quid, as is the Blackstar Amplug 2, but if you want a seriously good tone, a good portable tone, you've got to check out the Blackstar Fly. Not just any Blackstar Fly 3, this is the Blackstar Fly stereo rig. So I luckily already have a video on one of the Blackstar Fly, which I'll link in the description box down below so you can check it out. But this is that next level up. So the stereo features what looks like two Blackstar Flies. One of them is just an external speaker cab, so it's like an extra cabinet, as if it was a big Blackstar stack, but small and for the bedroom or wherever you want to use it. I'm not going to tell you where to use a Blackstar Fly. But yeah, the two speakers give you a full stereo tone, and Blackstar are so good at delivering stereo tone. The delay just kind of fills the room. It's wonderful, but not only that, it's 6 watts, 2 3-inch speakers, which have been specifically designed for the Fly 3. It's not like 6-inch speakers you get out of the back of a Tickle Me Elmo or something. Specifically designed for this. So the delay sounds awesome in stereo, but also if you play music through it, it sounds great through these stereo speakers because it has an MP3 line in as well. Back to guitar though, two channels, clean channel, distortion channel. You've got a gain control, how much distortion you want on that distortion channel or the clean channel. It's got an EQ control, which is Blackstar's patented ISF control, which is their infinite shape feature, which kind of switches between, do you want an American sounding amp or a British sounding amp? Do you want the mids to poke through like a British sounding amp, or do you want a slightly more scooped sound like a Fender or a Mesa Boogie on the more American side? And like I say, it's got that tape echo. Headphone line out as well. If you want to silently practice with your Blackstar Fly 3, these things sound absolutely unbelievable. A great gift for under 100 quid. Actually, on the box here, I've seen a few people use them in this application as speakers for a MacBook or a computer or something, as monitors. Sounds fantastic. When you do play music through as well, through the emulated, well, the line in, you can jam along with it. Like get along with backing tracks or your favorite song. The emulated line out isn't just for headphones. You can record directly out as well, so put it in an audio interface or something and get the tone of your Blackstar Fly 3 into your recording software. It runs on AA batteries in the back or a separate power supply. That's kind of it. Does everything it says on the tin. Look, this is the tin, and that's everything it does. Fantastic. This is mint. I love this setup, it's great. So this is under 500 quid now. Something is just off screen because I'm making room. Let's talk about this first. For the wonderful Yamaha THR32 wireless. Now the Yamaha THR, it's interesting because it was the first ever portable kind of amplifier out there, the original THRs. And they absolutely took the world by storm because they sounded just like a tube amp. Like the whole crack is that sounds like a, they've got the dynamics, the feel, the kind of work with your guitar like a real tube amp. That was the first edition. They didn't change the first edition for years. So many companies tried to copy that original Yamaha THR and put their own spin on it, which they did, and they were constantly developing and changing things. The original THR didn't change because it was still, by quite a long way in some cases, the best. They felt no need to change until last year, where they simply just made them a bit bigger and kind of trimmed down the lineup a bit and added some wireless functionality. Because Yamaha now own Line 6, who have lots of wireless goodies on the market. So this now has wireless capability. You can buy a wireless Line 6 G10, the little transmitter bug, charge it within this and have it in your guitar and practice wirelessly with your THR32 wireless. Not only that being wireless, this is also wireless in the sense that it also runs off a battery as well as through the mains. So it is totally wireless. And also the third little wireless factor is you can Bluetooth audio to it and play music through it, as well as download the Yamaha app, the mobile editor app, and change so much within this that you can't do from the top. I've had one of these for a little while now, and I do enjoy using the app, but I don't really change anything because out of the box it sounds bloody fantastic. Totally stereo again, very hi-fi quality. It's unbelievable how great the THR sound. It's just awesome. I had lots of crazy chorus on there in stereo in the room. It's just crazy. Echoes, reverbs, again, you can play music through. You can save up to 5 presets in it. There's a built-in tuner. What more could you want? Here are some tones from the THR. This is on the lead setting. So there's 15 amps, but it's 15 amplifiers. You can run a bass into it. You can run an acoustic guitar into it. You can run a flat. You can run a keyboard into it or something like that, just to amplify an instrument which just wants a flat kind of amplifier. So there's the standard kind of tones you'd want: clean, crunch, distortion, high gain, and special at the end, which is a lovely little. You have a lot of fun with the special control. There's also a little slider that goes between 3 different variations of each of those amplifiers. There's classic, boutique, and modern. So like say lead, Classic will be something like an old school Marshall. Boutique will be something like a matchless or some kind of modern boutique variation on an old school design. And a modern will be a modern interpretation of it. So like a classic hot rodded Marshall kind of. Let's throw some of these more effects. I'm on high gain now again. It sounds unbelievable in this room with the stereo filling all the empty spaces. It's a great gift for guitar, but I want one, another one. From that to so this is the THR30. There's a THR10, the smaller version of this, but the 30, given that 30 watts, it just sounds incredible. Like I say, it reacts and has the dynamics of a real valve amp. But not only does it look fantastic, so you'd have this on a shelf in your living room, but it sounds the mutt nuts. It's awesome. Speaking of the mutt nuts, let's move on to the next thing. The guitar I've been using throughout this entire video. This is an Epiphone 50s Les Paul Standard and Heritage Cherry Sunburst. And it's wonderful. And it's under 500 quid. The reason I like the 50s so much, the 50s Les Pauls, I love the 60s as well. The 60s Les Pauls are just magnificent, but the 60s is what the neck profile and the kind of vibe has always been for Les Pauls, unless it was a special edition, kind of 50s inspired one. An Epiphone Les Paul has always been somewhat 60s inspired. So the 50s is a great way to get that old school vibe and not have to spend a lot of money. It's bloody fantastic. You've got the mahogany body, the set mahogany neck with that 50s profile, 22 frets, you've got the big trapeze inlays and the flame maple top. Comes in a few fantastic finishes and it's just bloody fantastic. The new inspired by Gibson headstock up top as well. Aesthetically, it looks as good as it sounds, and damn does it sound good. And all that tone is thanks to the Pro Booker 2 and 3 pickups. You've got CTS controls, even got the little thumb bleeder pointers. But for me, it's the neck, because it's based off a 59 profile neck. And for a 59 profile, 59 style guitar for less than 500 quid, when real ones go for, in some cases, in the millions, something very, very special. So this is really good for under 500 quid. Such a bloody awesome guitar. And last but certainly not least, something I already have a video on, so I'm not going to demo right now. It's the Line 6 HX Effects. Now, speaking of Swiss Army guitar products, This is the Swissest of the Armiest Swiss Army you've ever seen. So this is the HX Effects. This has all the effects in from Line 6's very, very popular, very, very awesome Helix range. The HX range, those £1,000 amp and effects modelers. This has no amps in, it's just the effects. So if you're happy with your amplifier setup, your kind of rig as it is, but you don't know what pedals to get, or say your pedal board is getting a bit ridiculous, this has pretty much every single, over 100 effects, from vintage to modern, from standard regular effects like distortions, compressors, phasers and delays, to really avant-garde effects like step sequences and megaphone effects and drop tuners and everything in between. You can put external expression pedals in this as well to get wah sounds, whammy sounds. Use the expression to change the rate of delays and modulations. It's absolutely crazy. So for a one-stop shop for everything effect related, the HX Effects is a must-have. It's stereo, it's MIDI compatible. You can do everything with it. Absolutely everything. For under £500, it's a great gift for the guitarist in your life. Or if you're a guitarist, just want to treat yourself, this is the ultimate pedal board accessory, or all-in-one pedal board, I must say. And I think, ladies and gents, we've been here long enough. This is what I believe you should get for under £50, £100, and £500. If you want to expand on anything that was spoken about in this video, please comment down below. Add your own little favorite bit of gear people should buy for in those price brackets. And again, the prices do change all the time, so everything's linked in the description box down below, so you can check it out yourself. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more guitar and music related content. If you want to try anything out in this video that I spoke about, again, get yourself to your local PMT store and try them out for yourself. We are playing music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.